Yes, you are part of the interagency donor group, the IADG, on pro-poor livestock research and development. This group organized a trajectory to explore possibilities to coordinate the development investments of the dairy sector in East Africa. Can you tell us what the main outcome of the consultation meeting in Mbarara in Uganda is?
Well, I think the main outcome was that the great thing is that we had stakeholders from across the chain, from five different countries, and what I would say the main outcome is that everybody agrees with the bigger role of the private sector, that the donor role is more enabler and investor. Also, I think it was highly appreciated that knowing that more than 70 to 80% of the milk is from the informal chain, that we should look from a different perspective for the whole dairy sector and also look at the possibilities of integrating the more informal type of chains also into the dairy development. I think these were two major outcomes.
Why is such an initiative important in general? Maybe you can pinpoint the key issues briefly from the background.
Well, I mean, the simple reason why we started this trajectory is that we found out that almost all the major donors are investing in dairy development in East Africa, simply because it's very important for the nutrition, it's an important economic activity, and there's a growing demand. So it's, all these things together make that it was very relevant to have this trajectory and to look from with all the stakeholders to the development in the dairy sector in East Africa.
What are the main constraints that came out of this consultation in Uganda?
Well, I think the report made a very good basis, and next to what I already mentioned on the governance issue, also, and there was also a kind of pitch brought on, is how to get good quality heifers, pregnant heifers available for new farmers. That's, I think, a major issue because it's a long-term investment. Also, the issue of feeding and fodder as a critical one was extensively discussed. The development of cooperatives and finance cooperatives was came out within that quality-based payment systems. As I already mentioned, also issue of the, well, some people said we should not call it anymore informal sector, but for instance, we are still using a formal sector being the major one. How can you also include it in your development of the dairy sector, and also quality-based payment systems came up quite strongly, and the whole issue of capacity building. I think it was clearly expressed that we still have to work together on the question how to reach, say, 500,000 dairy farmers with basic capacity building. Nobody had really the answer on it because governments have retarded a little bit. It's not something cooperatives can really take out of the private sector, but that's something I think we really have to work on, how to come up with models and ways to do capacity building for a large number of farmers. Another one is that there are no good basic data on the dairy sector in all the countries.
Is there any idea more specifically steps how these constraints or specific ones could be tackled?
A number of ideas came up during the meeting. They will then be also worked out in the report. Also, there are already some groups working on issues. For example, SNP is working on feeding, and Gates Foundation has a program now on breeding. So there are different constraints because there were, of course, noticed earlier already some programs in development. So that will also be in the report. We'll list what kind of activities are being undertaken now for the different constraints, so everybody can share the learning experience in a different way.
To form the basis for the consultation, a new study has been drafted. It has the catchy title, White Gold Opportunities for Dairy Sector Development Collaboration in East Africa. What's the key recommendation of the authors?
Well, I think it's a whole set of recommendations. I think the first one is that, which I think is relevant to everybody, that a dairy sector with such veggies and vegetable product needs some regulation overall and needs coordination. So it's a, for dairy development, you need a kind of public-private test in which all the actors agree on the main issues and develop a trajectory to evade the different constraints. So I think that's a very important agreement which was reached.
So is there any indication how that could be facilitated? Is there anything new, better, that in a way that how this could be done?
Well, I think the representations from all the different countries really express that everybody has his own arrangement. For example, the Kenya Dairy Development Board, Rwanda has a dairy platform, and that is also, especially within the different countries, the arrangements have to be strengthened, and that across the countries, platform of the East African Community would be a good one for the different government agencies to interconnect.
Now, you are on the donor side in the meetings, and this is all very critically about the donor involvement. Where do you see the best inroads for donors? Where could they make a real difference in this whole initiative?
Well, I think what I said earlier, donors see themselves more as enablers and investors, and also as all the different donors expressed, that they would help to develop models, available models for inclusive change development. I think that is the main thrust of all the developments of the donors, and also to see how the private sector can play a bigger role in the whole development. And also the private sector says, please respect us, join us, and don't overfund different activities.
What are the next steps?
Well, the report is now under revision, so all the stakeholders have been asked to revise, come up with comments on the report. We as the guiding group of the interagency sat together and came up also with some conclusions that will be worked out now and shared with the participants.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.